Hello everyone, in this video we are going to design a disc brake rotor that you can see on the screen right now, and let's have a look. So now let us begin it. So let us move to the next part or the new part. Okay, then go to the sketch and select here the front plane. Now here we'll draw two concentric circles, then go to the smart dimension, and here this outer circle is of 170.54 mm, and this inner one is of 99.44 mm. Now we'll exit the sketch, then go to the features and select the extruded boss feature, and we'll extrude it for 4.5 mm, and okay. Now we'll go to the sketch and select this face normal. Now here first we'll insert a vertical center line, and then we'll draw one circle, then go to the smart dimension. Now the horizontal distance of the center of the circle from the center line, this distance is 31.07 mm, and the distance of the center of this circle and the center of this circle, the distance is 54.42 mm, and the diameter of the circle is 2.56 mm. Now we will insert a center line, and for that we will select here a center line, and we will draw a center line from the center of the circle like this, and then we will give the angle, and for that go to the smart dimension, and here this is the angle, that is 84.71 degree. Now we have to make the pattern for this circle. And for that first we will select this circle, then select here the linear sketch pattern, and here we will reverse the direction of the pattern, and the distance in between two consecutive circles is 5 mm, and we have to make 8 such circles, so enter here 8. And now we have to give the direction of the center line from the x-axis, and for that here we will enter 90 plus 84.71, and now we'll click on OK. Now we have to make another row, and for that we'll first draw a circle same way, then go to the smart dimension. Now the diameter of the circle is also same, that is 2.56 mm, and the distance of the circle from the center line, and that is 22.32 mm, and now the distance of this circle and this circle, this would be same, so it is 55.42 mm. Now we have to draw a center line from this center, so select here the center line and draw one center line like this. Then go to the smart dimension, and we'll give the angle. So here angle is 95.71 degree, and now we have to make the pattern for this circle, so we'll exit this and select the circle, then go to the linear sketch pattern. Now here we'll reverse the direction, so reverse the direction, and now we have to give the distance is 5 mm, and 8 such circles, and now the angle, that is 90 plus 95.71, and okay. So now this is our sketch, and we'll exit the sketch, then go to the features and select here the extruded cut feature. Now here we have to select that sketch and select here through all and okay. Now we have to make the pattern for this extrude cut, and for that first we'll select this extrude cut, then select here the circular pattern, then here we have to select that face and we have to make 7 such pattern, and for that enter here 7 and select here equal spacing and okay. Now we'll insert a plane, and for that go to the reference geometry, select here the plane, then select this face and we have to make a plane at a distance of 3.5 mm and okay. Now we have to mirror this part, and for that go to the mirror, then here we have to select this plane and select here bodies to mirror, and we have to select this body to mirror, and here we have to uncheck this merge solids and select OK. Now we'll hide this plane and then we'll sketch on this surface. For that go to the sketch and select here this face, go to the normal. Now here we have to draw one arc using the center point arc, so we'll select here the center point arc. First we'll select the center and then we'll select here this point and another point over here. Now we have to give the distances, and for that go to the smart dimension, then here the distance of this point from the origin, and that is the horizontal distance, that is 21.4 mm, and now the distance of this point from the origin, that is the horizontal distance, this is 22.39 mm, and now we have to exit the smart dimension. Now we'll draw one circle and we'll draw a circle like this, then go to the smart dimension, and this circle is having the diameter of 2.46 mm, and now we'll give the distances, so select the center of the circle and select here the origin, and this is the vertical distance, that is 82.36 mm, and now we'll give the horizontal distance. For that select the center point of this circle and select the center point, and now this is the horizontal distance, so the horizontal distance is 4.64 mm and okay. Now we have to make an arc, and for that we'll close the smart dimension, and after that we have to draw one arc, and for that we'll use the circle, so we'll draw one circle like this, and then we'll select this end point of this arc and select the circle and select here the coincident, okay, and then we'll select this circle, then select this circle and select here the tangent, and okay. Now we have to give the diameter of the circle, so select here the smart dimension, then select this circle, and here the diameter of the circle is 125 mm, and now we will exit the smart dimension, then go to the trim entities and we'll trim this bigger circle. After that click on OK. Now we have to do the same procedure for another arc, and for that we'll go to the circle and draw one circle like this, then we'll first select this end point of this arc, select the circle and select here the coincident and OK. Now we'll select this bigger circle and select this smaller circle and give it here the tangent and OK. Now we have to give the diameter of this bigger circle, and for that go to the smart dimension, select this bigger circle, and the diameter is 140 mm, okay. And now we will exit the smart dimension and we'll use the trim, so select the trim entities and we'll trim this bigger circle, and we have to also trim this inner side, so we'll trim this also. And now we'll exit the sketch. Then we'll go to the features and select here the extruded boss feature. Then select this last sketch. And now here we have to give the distance, and that is 7 mm, and okay. Now we'll close this. Then we have to give the circular pattern for this boss extrude. So we'll first select this, then select here the circular pattern. Now here we have to select this circular face. So we'll select this inner face, and we have to make 35 such ribs. So we'll enter here 35 and then click on OK. Now we'll draw one sketch. For that, go to the sketch and we have to select here the top plane and normal. Now here first we'll insert a vertical center line like this. Then we'll first start with the lines. So select here the line and we'll draw one horizontal line from this center line. Then again select line and we'll draw one vertical line and one horizontal line. Then go to the smart dimension. Now the distance between this edge and this line, that is 13 mm, and this is the 2 mm. Now we'll draw another portion, and for that we'll draw like this. Then go to the smart dimension. Now this vertical line is of 3.93 mm and this horizontal line is 6.41 mm and this line is 4.54 mm. Now we have to give the distance. So here this distance is 0.57 mm. And now the distance of this endpoint from this vertical center line, that is 44.4 mm. Then we'll exit the smart dimension. Now we'll choose the line and we'll draw inclined line like this, two inclined lines, and we'll make these both lines parallel. Okay, and now we have to give the angle. For that, go to the smart dimension, select this line and the center line, and we have to give the angle. So the angle is 2 degrees. Now we'll exit the smart dimension, and we have to extend these two lines. So we will extend these lines like this. Then we'll go to the trim entities and we'll trim out these all entities and also these entities. Now our sketch is completed. So we'll exit the sketch. Then go to the features, select here the revolve boss feature, and then click on OK. Now we have to give the fillet, and for that go to the fillet. Then fillet radius is 1 mm, and we have to select this edge and OK. Now we'll go to the sketch and select here this face normal. Now first here we'll draw a concentric circle, and we have to give the diameter, that is 26 mm, and after that we have to draw one circle like this. Then go to the smart dimension. Now here the diameter of this circle is 6.7 mm and distance of this circle from the origin, that is 24 mm. And now we have to make 5 such circles. So select first this circle, then go to the circular pattern, and we have to make 5 such circles. So enter here 5 and then click on OK. And now we'll exit this sketch. Then go to the features and select here the extruded cut feature and select here through all and OK. Now we have to give the appearance. For that first we'll make here plain white we'll select the revolve and all this, then go to the appearance and we have to select here the painted, and here we have to select the car and select this red color. Now we have to give the appearance to other parts, and for that we'll select all these features, then go to the appearance and in the metal we have to go for the nickel and select here this polished nickel. Okay, so this is the disc brake rotor that we have done using the SolidWorks.